With me tonight in the McDowell High School Fieldhouse on the McDowell High School campus is Coach David Turner, McDowell Daredevils. We're going to be filming this game tonight between the Daredevils of McDowell and the Sheldon Clark Indians. Coach Turner?
Cardinals,
right. Coach Turner, how do you feel about this game tonight and what are your prospects tonight about beating the Sheldon Clark Cardinals?
Well, I understand Sheldon Clark has lost two starters since we played them last over there. We beat them 81 to 70. But I understand they just came off of a big game over at Virgie. I think maybe in the third quarter they were 1 point ahead of Virgie at one time, so they played Virgie a good ball game. If we play our ball game, though, I think we ought to be able to win.
Do you anticipate anything different from the game at Sheldon Clark? I recall early in the year you had one of your better games at Sheldon Clark and had them down about 20 points at halftime. I think you went away beating them something like 10 or 11 points. Do you anticipate anything different from Sheldon Clark?
Well, their personnel is a little different. They have two new starters. But I really don't think they'll play. Their game plan will be basically the same. They usually start out in a man-to-man, then they go to some kind of zone. Now, they played us a 1-3-1 the last half over there. Maybe they may go to that this game, but I don't look for them to stay in it long.
Well, Coach, I know you've had a good season. Your record is 17-9, and I know you're looking forward to have another 20-game season. What do you think your prospects are in the tournament?
Well, we have 5 ball games left. If we can pick up 3 wins, that'll make us our 20-game season. And then we're in a tough bracket in the tournament. We start off with Prestonsburg, and we're in the same bracket with Betsy Lane. They have a bye. So I don't know. I think if we can just put it together here in these next 5 ball games that we have left, get our spirits up a little bit and go into the tournament with a little momentum, we ought to be in good shape.
Well, I know you played a good schedule this year, and you have some good ball players, and I feel like that if you can get a little momentum going, you have a type of ball club that could just go all the way, and not only in the district but the regional. So good luck to you and your Daredevils, and hopefully you'll come away tonight with a victory.
Thank you, Coach.
I have with me tonight the coach of the Sheldon Clark Cardinals, Coach John Williams. He's an old friend of mine. When I used to coach, he was in the coaching business also. And we're good friends in spite of having to play a lot of ball games against each other. But they had to bring John out of retirement. And now he's at it again, rebuilding Sheldon Clark. So, buddy, it's good to have you over here. Good to see you again. Are you satisfied with your building here so far?
Oh, yeah. I got 2 good real sophomores and a good junior and a good freshman, so we'll be back.
How many games have you won this year, John? What's your record?
It's 4-16.
But really, you played a real good schedule. I noticed you played the top teams in Eastern Kentucky.
I feel like I've played the best in Eastern Kentucky.
Do you feel like your boys are coming along as young as they are?
Yeah, I feel like I've got as good a sophomores as I'll play against in the region. I don't believe I'll go up against any better sophomores.
Well, John, do you anticipate doing anything different tonight against McDowell? I know you played them over at Sheldon Clark in December, but I was just wondering if you have any special plans or what you're going to try to do tonight here at McDowell.
No, I'll do about the same thing, play good man-to-man defense and try to score.
Do you feel like it? What do you have to do to win this game at McDowell tonight?
Well, we're going to have to play the way we did Saturday night at Virgie. We're going to have to cut our turnovers down, hit our foul shots, and take good shots in the field.
Well, John, I know you've been a very successful coach in the business, and I'd like for you to just give fans and all of us a comparison. I know you were out of coaching for a few years. How many was that exactly?
I was out 7 years.
All right, John was out 7 years, and he coached back in the 50s and 60s. In early 70s when I did, and when I was at McDowell and John was at Warfield, which was later consolidated into Sheldon Clark. So I was just wondering if you could give the fans out there a comparison of a difference in coaching now in the 80s as compared to the 50s, 60s, and the 70s?
That's a tough question, Pete. That's putting a fella right on the spot now.
Is there as much emphasis now in the game around here, John?
Well, I don't believe overall basketball's as strong as it was back in the 50s and 60s. I don't see the as strong of boys. I don't see the dedication. They're just a hard-nosed basketball. Most of your kids now will maybe let the other guy score just so they can get the ball. Where a few years ago, you may have to get knocked down or go over somebody, you know. And I see a big difference that way.
I feel like, John, that years ago there used to be a lot of dedicated mountain boys playing the game of basketball. Now, if you're dedicated, a dedicated athlete stands out like a sore thumb, it appears to me.
Yeah, I agree with you. You find fewer really boys that are dedicated to the game, and I feel like that I'm fortunate and I've got a couple, three like that.
Well, John, I want to wish you all the success in the world. I hope, and with these freshmen and sophomores you have coming, and I saw your B team, you have a good bunch coming, I hope you get to coach those boys and you don't quit before someone else reaps the rewards. I know a lot of hard work has gone into the program over there, and I know that people appreciate the job that you're doing for them. I'd just like to wish you all the success in the world, except tonight I can't hardly wish you too much success against the Daredevils, and particularly when I got a son out there playing too. So best of luck to you. I hope to see you in the regional tournament.
Thank you, Pete. And you know what, I like to win at MacDowell.
I know that. We've had some humdingers. John Williams, head coach of the Sheldon Clark Cardinals.
Do a pretty good job of that, son. Is that what you're going to go into when you get out of school administrative work?
I have with me Marty Spurlock, who is going to do the play-by-play tonight, and I'll be doing the commentary. Marty? Do you anticipate a wild and woolly game, or what do you expect of this game tonight?
Coach, from all my years of attending the ball games here at MacDowell, it's always been a wild and woolly game in this gymnasium. Even in the new gym and the old gym past, we had some real wild games over there.
Absolutely. And Marty, here's the starting lineup that you'll be calling. MacDowell will be starting Pete Grigsby III at guard. He is number 35. Steve Hobart, a senior, at the other guard, number 12. Jimmy Turner, 6'9", junior center, number 52, will start at the center position. Roger Moore, a senior, number 30. And Frank Johnson, number 34, a senior forward, will be starting at the other forward. MacDowell is 17-9 on the season, and they had defeated Sheldon Clark once earlier at Sheldon Clark. Sheldon Clark, Marty, will start John Kirk, number 14, at one guard. Brian Maynard, number 21, at the other guard, along with Teddy Duncan at center, number 34, Garfield Horn, number 25, at one forward, and Morgan Horn, number 11, at the other forward. So we're about ready to start, Marty, in this game, and I'm going to be turning this over to you to play the play in just a minute.
Coach, I'll have to apologize for my appearance to the folks tonight. I just got through refereeing the B-team game, and I sure wish these officials a whole lot of luck tonight because I know they're going to need it.
All right, here we are, about ready at Grigsby Fieldhouse to start the ball game.
Coach, we're just about getting ready to have the starting lineups announced here and introduced to the crowd from the public PA system. Folks, we'd like to welcome you here tonight to the Grigsby Fieldhouse here in MacDowell, Kentucky.
No, you go ahead with the lineup. Be okay.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's welcome to EPE Community Fieldhouse. Tonight's basketball game between the Sheldon Clark Cardinals and the Seattle Mariners. Here's the Sheldon Clark Cardinals. I won God number 14, John Kirk. The other guy, number 21, Brian Leonard. And the center position, number 34, Kenny Bunyan. At one forward spot, number 25, Garfield Horn. At the other forward, number 11, Jordan Horn. The third one is coached by John Williams. Now for the man with the McDowell.
Coach, this will be my first time seeing the Cardinals play tonight. It appears to me that right now McDowell has a tremendous size advantage against the Cardinals, and I'm curious to see what will happen on the boards tonight.
Of course, well,
McDowell led it in the post position by Jimmy Turner at 6'9". Looks to me like the tallest player that the Cardinals have is their center, number 34, who looks to be about 6'4".
Yes, McDowell has a definite height advantage. And over at Sheldon Clark, McDowell played probably one of the better halves of the season. They were leading Sheldon Clark at 20. Sheldon Clark has lost three or four of their boys since early in the season, since they played that game. Coach Williams was explaining to me in the pregame talk. So you look for McDowell. If they play steady, they should be able to handle the Cardinals, but you know how basketball is.
Well, Coach, we're just about ready for the jump ball here to start the game. Jumping in center for McDowell will be Jimmy Turner. And number 34 for Sheldon Clark, Teddy Duncan. And McDowell controls the tip. And Johnson controls it, gives it back across to Halbert. Halbert over to Grigsby. Grigsby dribbling across the court. Throws it into the lane to Moore. Moore puts it up. Good.
That was one of their special feeds into the post, Grigsby in there to Moore. They work that a lot of times against zone defenses.
Sheldon Clark with the ball now on this end. As the guards feed it around the horn, down in the corner to number 21, Brian Maynard. Maynard back to Kirk. Kirk out in the post to Duncan. And Grigsby pulls down the rebound after the shot for Sheldon Clark. Grigsby motoring it on down the court. As he goes through the lane all the way uncontested for the layup, puts it up and misses it. Coach, I think McDowell's got it in their mind they want to run with the ball tonight.
It looks like it. I know Coach has changed his 1-3-1. He has Grigsby on the wing and Halbert on the point and Moore on the baseline on his 1-3-1.
Is this for rebounding purposes? Or?
It appears to be for rebounding purposes, Marty.
I know that Sheldon Clark seems to work for the good shot each time down the court, although they did put up a very low percentage shot the last time.
I think you'll see them to be pretty patient on offense. They generally play that way, particularly when they have a disadvantage in height. We might mention, Marty, that McDowell is being led by Grigsby with a 23-point average this year, and Turner, 6'9", junior, at a 14-point average, and Roger Moore, number 30, approximately a 14-point average. So they have three boys that usually score in double figures.
Coach McDowell seems to be moving pretty well on their 1-3-1 defense tonight. I don't notice they caused a turnover on the other side. And now they have the ball coming back down the court. I think Moore got a little bit over-aggressive there, trying to go one-on-one when he should have been passing the ball.
He was running a basic second guard pattern and tried to go one-on-one. The cutoff would have been, Grigsby would have been cutting off him tight to receive the pass. But Moore decided to freelance on.
Well, Sheldon Clark put up another pretty high percentage or pretty low percentage shot, but they made that one. I think that was put up by Kirk on the other side.
There's a turnover. The Daredevils have made two in a row now. So we're going to have to watch these turnovers, even if Sheldon Clark is young.
Well, they seem to be picking Sheldon Clark up high on the defense, trying to force the ball, force all the play to the outside. Kirk has the ball coming around to Maynard. Maynard going one-on-one, puts a shot up over Turner, blocked by Turner. Pulls it down on the, out on the break is Halbert, number 12. Puts it up off the glass, no good. Rebound by Johnson, back up, no good. Pulled off by Grigsby, up, no good. Pulled down by Moore, puts it up, good. Coach, that goes to proves if you take enough shots, you're going to make one of them.
Absolutely. Four tries there. McDowell finally puts it down.
I think that just goes to show what we illustrated at the beginning of the game, that McDowell has a definite size advantage, and they are going to be tough on the boards tonight. Maynard around to Kirk. Kirk puts it up. No good. And pulled off by Harry Horn. Kirk puts it up, and she's good again. Kirk, boy, seems to be a pretty good outside shooter.
Well, so far, I believe he has both baskets, Martin.
Yeah, he's taking all the shots that Sheldon Clark has taken from the outside. Grigsby driving around, off the post, up, no good, he's fouled.
That's McDowell's bread and butter play for a penetrating guard like Grigsby. They like to clear out of side and then pick against a man-to-man, and that gives Grigsby, who is a good one-on-one player, an opportunity to do his thing, and you saw it in action there.
Well, I think the it was well recognized by Grigsby that Turner was coming up to set high for him. I don't know if the play was called, but he saw the high post pick set, and he used it.
They run that play by a signal from a guard to the center and the forwards, and that's how come they know what's where to pick and how to go. They're in a zone press after fouls,
yeah.
Marty.
Kirk puts it up from 20, good. I think they're going to have to put a little bit more pressure on Kirk over here if they want to control this outside shot. Here McDowell's found himself down.
Here
There's
comes Sheldon
Clark out on the break. There's good body control over there. Sheldon Clark settled down, takes a 25-footer, and it's good. These Mountain boys can shoot.
Well, what happened there was a mix-up on the defense assignments. Halbert forgot to go out front on the 1-3-1. He hung in there on the baseline. And, of course, like you said, they gave a 20-footer to Sheldon Clark. And I don't believe you can do that with this team. I believe that apparently they have two good set shooters in Garfield Horn and Kirk, number 14. So I suppose Coach Turner called time to apply a little more pressure on those two shooters.
Well, I noticed that at the beginning of the game, I have watched most of the games that McDowell's played this year and missed their last two games, but you noticed that tonight they've changed their 1-3-1 and moved Halbert out to the front and Grigsby down on the wing and put Moore back on the baseline. Moore is a quicker player and he can run the baseline a little bit quicker, but Halbert has a little bit of trouble remembering that he's supposed to play on the front and not underneath.
Absolutely. He forgot to adjust, and that caused the basket to go down. I think the main thing McDowell's going to have to adjust to is the turnovers that they've committed. I think they've had three or four already, and the first quarter is not completed.
Well, Coach, what do you tell a player that's committing it? I would call it an unforced turnover because it's mostly happening from the guard to the forward position.
Well, you know, I think the players are trying to do just what you said. They're trying to force the offense. You can't do that. You got to get in the flow of a game and take the options that you're given on your offense and just play naturally.
Here comes Sheldon Clark out on the break again. And here the ball comes down on the low post. Out on the wing to Garfield Horn. He puts it up, and it's good. Coach, it looks to me like they're going to have to start favoring the wing side a little bit more. They're a little overshifting just a little bit on their zone and not forcing that wing shot over there. And the guy took it into the low post to Turner that time and got a foul. I would think, Coach, that they would have to go in more loaded to Turner tonight and use the size advantage that they have. What is your opinion on that?
Well, it looks to me like that they're starting to do that. The turnovers, I believe, have kept them from going inside and getting the good percentage shot. We'll have to wait and see what develops. Well, there's another turnover. So we've had, I haven't got the accurate count, but we must have five turnovers here in 4.5 minutes.
I think McDowell's trying to force the play just a little bit much. Here comes Sheldon Clark back over the timeline, over the horn, back to the point to Kirk. Kirk brings it around to Maynard. Maynard back to Kirk. Kirk over to horn. Horn down low to, looks like Duncan. Duncan takes a shot and down pulled off the board by Turner. Turner brings it out to Grigsby. He runs the ball up to court. Cuts it off. Looks like the ball was knocked out of bounds by Sheldon Clark at that time. Turner will trigger the inbounds play for Grigsby, correction. Grigsby into Moore, over to Halbert in the point. Halbert seems to be setting up his play. Here he goes to Moore on the high post. Moore has the ball slapped away, stolen away by Sheldon Clark, down into Kirk. Kirk one on, and to Maynard. Maynard walks with the ball.
This is highly unusual for the Daredevils to have this many turnovers. I don't know. This man-to-man isn't that tough. It just seems like it. We're not executing with confidence.
Oh, there was a very obvious push there, Coach. Foul's on number 34, Duncan. Turner will trigger the ball down low inbounds. A new player checking in the game, Robert Smith. He's a pretty big boy going in there. Is he a football player?
He must be. He's a good-sized boy.
Turner triggers in into Moore. Moore takes one dribble, shoots it up. No good. He was fouled on the shot by Kirk. McDowell seems to be playing a little timid tonight. They don't seem to be very sure of what they want to do out there.
Yeah, they're not as aggressive as they usually are. Of course, this early, they might be a little, it might be too relaxed, and could be the answer for why they aren't executing properly.
Well, Coach, I think the key to McDowell's success is Grigsby, and he's not touching the ball as much as he usually does at the beginning of a game. And that, I think McDowell's going to have to start recognizing who their shooter is and who their bread-and-butter player is and go to him a little bit more to get them settled down and get started in the play.
I believe they'll start doing that, particularly when you have Turner who can play well inside and Grigsby good outside.
After Halbert makes both free throws, McDowell's pressing. They give it down to over to Kirk. Kirk puts up a Hail Mary shot. Moore rebounds, brings it in to Grigsby. Grigsby runs it down the court. Over to Halbert, good pass. Halbert puts it up and missed a shot. Turner pulls it down, takes it back up and in. Grigsby made a very good pass there from coming on the wing over into the breaking Halbert as he broke across the lane. Sheldon Clark back down with the ball as Maynard has it in the corner. Smith on the baseline. Back to Smith. Smith to Maynard. Maynard to Kirk. Kirk brings it over to number 21. We've got a foul underneath on the rebound. Foul is on Horn.
25. Yeah, he was pushing in there, Marty, and the referee caught him. Looks like we got a bonus for McDowell.
The bonus early in this game. Yeah. At the line for McDowell will be number 30, Moore. Moore has been a pretty fair free throw shooter on the season. Probably one of the top free throw shooters for McDowell. As he takes his time, takes a couple of dribbles and puts it up and bounces it in.
That tied it up, Marty, 10 all.
McDowell has made a run here in the last minute or so. Moore puts it up again, good.
I think McDowell's starting to settle down a little bit now.
The last two or three times down the court, Coach, as you noticed what I said a while ago, the man who handled the ball was Grigsby, and he's kind of settled him down.
I think
there's
so.
There's a steal on the fast break. Moore brings it down over to Halbert, who brings it across the timeline. Halbert down to, there's a foul underneath. As it tried to go low to McDowell, Horn came across his back. Moore will be at the free throw line again. I think McDowell reacted pretty well on that fast break that time, Coach.
Yes, they did. I think they're starting to get the transition game going, and they're best when they are moving up and down the floor and playing good, hard, fast basketball. That may loosen up their shooting and their ball handling.
Coach, one of the things I know that you stressed in coaching was filling the lanes on the fast break and even on the defensive end on the fast break. And McDowell filled the lanes pretty well the last time, got the turnover, went back down and got the foul and scored. Auburn very unalert on that play, lost the ball.
That's hard to explain when that happens in a game. Why a boy, would not be alert on something like that.
Maynard with the ball back out front to Kirk. Kirk puts it up. Good.
Well, he's red hot.
He sure is. I don't think Colbert's putting enough pressure on Kirk out here on front. Colbert seems to me like he's not within the flow of the game, Coach. He's just not active, staying around, not doing much. That's a good rebound by Johnson, put back up and in on the missed shot by Grigsby. Maynard ran across for Sheldon Clark across the timeline. He gives it over to Kirk. Kirk goes low to Horn. Horn brings it into Garfield. Horn stolen away. Halbert with the ball going up the court. Cuts across. Waits for the rest of the players to come down. Feeds it over to Johnson. Johnson takes one dribble into the lane. Pops. And it's good.
Well, McDowell's regained the lead, 15-14.
They still don't seem to me like they're playing very good ball, though, Coach. The point guard out here seems very unsure of himself. I saw a game like this on TV the other day against one of the college games where the point guard had two or three turnovers right at the beginning of the game. I think it was the Virginia-Clemson game. More to Grigsby. Grigsby puts it up. No good. As the clock runs out the end of the first quarter.
Well, we had a very even quarter there. I think the difference definitely was McDowell's turnovers and inability to hit some pretty close-in shots. Even though Sheldon Clark managed 14 points on long-range shooting, I could very well see how McDowell could at least be up by 10 points.
I would venture to say that McDowell had the more shots that time and had the higher percentage shots. The only difference was McDowell's shots weren't going in and Sheldon Clark's was. Sheldon Clark took a lot of outside shots that first quarter and made quite a few shots. I would venture to say that their shooting percentage for the first quarter was very high. McDowell's was very low.
Isn't that strange? You know, McDowell had the better percentage shots, but yet I'd say there's at least 20% difference in shooting, maybe 30% at this point in the game. So it shows you that even when you are working your strategy and things are going right, if you don't put in the basket, you're not going to win.
That's exactly right. McDowell comes out to start of the second quarter with the same lineup they started the first quarter with. And the only change in the Sheldon Clark lineup is number 45, Smith, Robert Smith. He'll jump center against Jimmy Turner. The ball goes up. Turner taps down to Grigsby on the fast break. Lays it up. Good.
Nice tilt by Turner. I've seen him execute that play this year from time to time. It's a good play.
As Sheldon Clark brings it back across the timeline, Kirk handling on the point. Back over to Maynard. Maynard back to Kirk. Kirk over to Garfield. Horn. Horn down to the other Horn. Horn over to Smith. Smith back to Horn. Horn to Maynard. Maynard over to Kirk. Back to Horn in the corner. Over to Horn for the jump shot. No good. And the ball is slapped out of bounds. Going to be given to White. The referee yells. As McDowell gets the ball coming back up the court the other way. Of course, I noticed that Sheldon Clark used the old basic fundamentals of basketball there where you try to feed the ball around the horn real quick to overload the defense on one side and feed back to the weak side to get the shot.
Absolutely. They run that wing shooter through the baseline, see, hoping to get him open. And it's a basic pattern against his own defense in this area.
Looks like McDowell had another turnover down in the other end.
Yeah, once again, I feel like they're trying to force the execution. They're not taking what the defense has given them. And they're going to have to relax and do that.
Maynard has it back over to Horn. Horn to Kirk for Sheldon Clark. Takes one dribble, feeds it over to Maynard on the wing. Maynard spins, dribbles, shoots it up. Ball bounces a couple times, no good. Maynard goes in and gets the rebound himself, takes it up, and he's hammered.
Who was that? Roger Moore, I think.
Roger Moore, I think, got that one. That goes back to the basic fundamentals of basketball again. He says, don't give him the layup, but don't let him make it.
Who's the foul on there? Okay, on Turner. I thought it was on Moore.
Foul was on
Turner. We have to correct that. 6'9", junior, Jim Turner.
Turner must have got him before Moore clobbered him. Moore did clobber him over there on the other side. Maynard missed one free throw, puts the other up and gets it. McDowell holds the lead right now, 17-15. The ball comes into Hallert, back to Grigsby. Coach, I notice Grigsby's handling the ball now, just like we said he had to do. Grigsby to Turner, up, good.
I think you'll notice when Grigsby penetrates, he's looking for Turner most of the time. Only thing, I think Turner should be hanging in closer to basket than what he is when he does penetrate.
Well, there's a rebound that came outside. It looked to me like McDowell was a little bit sleep on. Everybody looked everybody else to get the rebound. As Sheldon Clark comes down with it. Horn has it on their wing over here. Back to Maynard to Kirk. Kirk takes one dribble, gives it back to Maynard. Maynard back to Kirk. Kirk over to Horn, puts it up. No good. Johnson down with the rebound, out to Moore. As McDowell has thoughts about running it down, but gives it back over to Grigsby, and he slows it down. Grigsby's calling his play, calls Halbert over to get the ball, feeds it off to Halbert, Halbert to Moore. Moore comes around, takes a couple dribbles, stand holding with the ball over to Johnson now. Johnson gives it back out front to Grigsby. Grigsby backs out and sets up his play again, gives it back
Sheldon to Halbert. Sheldon Clark's gone to their 2-1-2 zone, Marty, and that's what McDowell just realized.
Petey misses it, no good. Moore trying for the rebound, slaps it out of bounds. It took them just a little bit of time to recognize that Sheldon Clark had backed off into the zone that time.
Well, they'll do that. They'll change to a 2-1-2 or 1-3-1 trap or 1-3-1 back. And you have to be alert to watch the change. I think we're also seeing the McDowell adjustment to moving some of his players around. He's kind of experimenting a little bit with his defense tonight. That's why they don't seem as aggressive as they usually are. It's simply because Coach Turner is trying to get a little more rebound strength on his 1-3-1 by moving Grigsby to a wing.
We've got a timeout on the court right now. Yeah, in the court here now. I think the ball will be Sheldon Clark's as they had the ball when time was called. They'll have it on the side over here.
5:13 to go, Marty. McDowell on top, 21-15. This is the second quarter action.
McDowell seems to be picking up their play a little bit of their tempo. I think Coach Turner's pulled them out to apply a little bit more pressure on their defense to get their defense moving a little bit. Our Turner intimidated Maynard that time, but then throws the ball away.
Another turnover.
We've got Kirk Cannon on the wing over here. Takes one dribble, gives it down in the corner to Horn. Horn takes one dribble, puts it up. No good. Tipped out to Horn on the top of the key. Horn down to Kirk in the corner. Takes shot. No good. This seems to be like one of those nights, Coach, when you do everything you're supposed to do and do it right, and then all of a sudden something goes wrong. We got a foul underneath on the Grigsby on the rebound.
Well, they still aren't in the bonus yet. McDowell's in the bonus. Sheldon Clark isn't. I think the referees are allowing a lot of bumping underneath the boards, Marty.
It looks to be that way. I noticed McDowell had the rebound about four or five different times there and lost it on the play previously down the court. Sheldon Clark back with the ball on this end of the court, working it around to Horn, over to Maynard, into Horn. Horn back out to Maynard on the wing. Maynard back on top to the other Horn. Horn works it around, gives it back over on the wing to Horn as he moved across the lane. Down in the corner to Kirk. Kirk back to Horn. Horn to Horn. Up, no good. Rebound come off long. And Johnson went up for the rebound. Horn came across his back for the foul. We'll go back down on the other end and shoot a bonus as Frank Johnson will be at the line.
This is a characteristic of Coach Johnny Williams' ball clubs. You'll find that they always box out real hard, and they do a lot of maneuvering around underneath the boards, legal or illegal, and he teaches a good hard-nosed game underneath the boards, and McDowell's having a little problem with this right now.
McDowell's problem most of the year has been the playing against teams that box out real well. They don't seem to recognize the fact that they are being boxed out and then try to maneuver for their own position. I think too often a player gets lulled into the attitude of wanting to jump all the time for his rebounds.
There's the second one up and good, 23-17. Daredevils on top by six.
Sheldon Clark triggers it in to Maynard. Maynard back to Horn. Horn brings it up real quick over to Horn in the corner, who turns around and shoots. No good. Rebound comes off to Smith. Smith throws it out on the wing to Kirk, who had to run down to get it. Kirk dribbles it back down on the wing, over to Horn on the point, over to Horn on the wing. Horn into Maynard on the low post. Turner goes up to block the shot. Grigsby blocked off real well that time, Coach.
Yes, he did a good job there. You're going to have to give Coach Turner's troops a little time. They're working in different defensive positions, and I can already tell a little improvement out there. They're getting more aggressive. He's sending Petey to the board on one wing there, on one side, and he blocked out real well, and drew the foul and got the rebound.
I notice also, Coach, if they can get a little bit more stronger play on the point from Halbert, a little bit of stronger play on the wing, on the far wing over there, that McDowell should be able to do a little bit better. I noticed Grigsby had the rebound coming off that time and was ready to go all the way up the court with it by himself on the fast break to lead it off.
He was ready to push the fast break down the floor.
Grigsby with the second free throw up and good.
25-17. Daredevils now begin to make their move.
Horn brings it in to Maynard, who brings it all the way up the court. Moore trying to cut off, gets there a little late and is called for blocking.
There's a basic fault. When you're trying to trap, you can't be moving with the player. You got to get in front of him and set the block.
Coach McDowell, by virtue of playing the zone, has still not put Sheldon Clark in the bonus situation yet. And Sheldon Clark triggers it on the inbounds play. Horn comes over to Horn. Horn into Maynard. Maynard tries to go up over Turner and puts it up and good. Grigsby brings it into Halbert. Halbert nonchalantly bringing it down the court. Triggers it over to Moore on the wing, down to Johnson in the corner. Corner into Turner. Turner puts it up twice and makes it the second time.
Good follow there, Mark.
Kirk bringing the ball up to court, brings it over to Maynard. The ball is stolen away by McDowell. Feeds it into Grigsby. Grigsby puts it up. No good. Short. Johnson on the follow. Up and good.
Nice hustle by Frank Johnson, who stole the ball, kicked it off, and followed a missed shot and put in the rebound.
And Sheldon Clark rushes it down the court against the 1-3-1 of McDowell. Kirk with the ball, wants to shoot and can't. Takes a dribble down to the baseline now, puts it up and good. Turner brings it off, feeds it over to Grigsby, who's going to push it down the court. Feeds on a long pass to Johnson, who stops, puts it up and good. Horn into Kirk. Kirk pushing it down, trying to beat the defense back.
Well, there's an example of what the Daredevils do best, Marty, and that's the fast break. When they get the ball to Grigsby in the middle and fill the lanes.
There's another steal, Coach.
When they fill those lanes on the fast break and Grigsby's in the middle, they're unstoppable.
As Grigsby realized very quick that Johnson was breaking way down in front of him on the left side, that's the advantage of dribbling with your head in the air so you can see down court. Sheldon Clark with the ball, triggers it over to Horn to Maynard, feeding that, working that low post. Back to Horn in the corner, puts it up, no good. There's Grigsby off of the rebound, and he's going with it, trying to. He's blocked off by Horn, he's called for the foul.
Nice call by Varela.
Another example, Coach, of what we were talking about before when Grigsby was in for the rebound. He is a good rebounding guard, one of the best rebounding guards we have in the area here. Pulls the rebound off and is ready to go with it after that.
That's the advantage of having a guard his size who can push a ball down the floor after he rebounds. He can cause a lot of problems to the opposing team.
The shot is up and good. What is Grigsby's free throw percentage on the year, Coach?
It's been anywhere between 75 and 79%. He could be a 80-85% foul shooter, I think, with a lot of work.
Well, he does work awful hard on his playing. Puts the second shot up and good. Sheldon Clark comes off with the rebound and brings it all the way down to Horn. Horn thinks better of it since he ran into Turner underneath there and brings it back out. Maynard's got it on the low post now, trying to work. Throws it over to Horn in the corner, brings it out to Horn on the front. Horn back to Horn. Horn back over to Horn. To Kirk, who wanted to put it up, tries to go over to Grigsby now and finds up short. Back up to Grigsby on the wing, who's going to push it down again. Grigsby with his head in the air, dribbling down, takes it all the way. Good.
Excellent penetration that time. And that shows you, with the ball in the middle, what the Daredevils can do on the break.
McDowell is almost up with a steal again that time. Sheldon Clark pulls it out and sets it up. We've got Kirk with the ball on the wing, over to Horn on the point. Down in the corner to Horn, who puts it up. No good. Rebound comes off to Turner. He's going to Grigsby on the wing, who's going to push it down the court again. Grigsby feeds to Hallward, who stops, pops, no good. And Horn for Sheldon Clark pulls it off the board, and he's going to push it down. I don't think Hallward was ready for the pass that time, Coach.
No, he wasn't. He didn't have his balance on his shot.
Maynard up with a shot that time. Grigsby working the ball down the court on the right side. Looking into Turner, feeds it over the back. And we've got an offensive foul being called on Grigsby.
You have McDowell on top, 34-21, with 8 seconds to go in the first half. They've made their run, it looks like, Marty. They're going to go in the dressing room with at least a 13 or 11-point lead. We'll see what happens.
Here comes Sheldon Clark down on the over to Horn on the Horn on the wing. He puts it up high, no good. And the score here at halftime has McDowell 34, Sheldon Clark 21. Coach, we noticed in the first quarter where Sheldon Clark was hitting their long-range shots and making them. Here come down in the second quarter, they were trying the same shots and they weren't falling, and McDowell was coming off with the rebound, pushing it down the court, had a lot of transition baskets, and run the score up here. Now they're 13 points up at halftime.
I think what we saw, Marty, was adjustment by Coach Turner on his defense. If you notice, there was more pressure on those wing shooters, and it looks like Coach Turner had his wing players to move the shooters out another 3 feet, maybe possibly a little beyond their shooting range, their normal shooting range. So therefore, you saw a lot of their shots hitting the front of the rim, and McDowell coming up with the rebound. So I think a little more pressure, like you said earlier, was what Coach Turner did on that adjustment, and to push the Sheldon Clark shooters out beyond the range by a step.
Now, you're the coach of McDowell now. You're going in 13 points up. What do you tell your boys in the locker room?
Gee, Marty, I think they've done an excellent job in a lot of ways. I would tell them to do what they've been doing. I think we need to put more pressure out on the point. Of course, Hallward hadn't played out there this year. This is his first chance there. And I would get into transition game like they've been doing. I would tell them to take the first percentage shot they had. I think they're trying to over-execute at times. I think I'm an advocate of what Coach Rupp used to believe at Kentucky. When you have the open 15-footer, take it, because that's as good a shot you're going to get at that time.
Well, let's switch and put you on Coach Williams' side of the ball court. You're down by 13 at halftime. What do you tell your boys?
Well, definitely, Coach Williams, it looks like he's not going to be able to establish the inside game. I'd say probably he'll try to do that. Turner's been very intimidating to Sheldon Clark on the inside. However, he must realize that McDowell is forcing his shooters out beyond the range, and I look for him to try to go to inside while at the same time get his shooters in a step closer if he possibly can, and maybe even be more patient on offense. But then again, he could try to go with the flow, so to speak, and come back and put a lot of pressure on McDowell to see how McDowell handles the pressure. Of course, I think the way McDowell's playing, but that will just enhance McDowell's opportunity here to go ahead and loosen up a little more.
Here we have the score at halftime. McDowell 34, Sheldon Clark 21. Let's take a break. We'll be right back.
Well, here we are back at courtside at halftime. The score 34-21 in favor of McDowell over Sheldon Clark. Here's the scoring at halftime for the Sheldon Clark Cardinals. John Kirk has 6 points. He's number 14, a guard for Sheldon Clark. Brian Maynard, a guard, number 21, has 9 points. So the two guards, Marty, have 15 points out of their 21 total.
Coach, I think Maynard worked mostly on the low post there during the game. He got most of his points on a turnaround jumper there off the low post, shooting against four on the turnaround jump shot. Kirk's 6 points came in the first quarter on three long jumpers from the wing over here. The other scorer for Sheldon Clark was Garfield Horn, number 25 playing forward. He also had 6 points. Most of Sheldon Clark's point production has come from the outside shot, and the only points they are getting on the inside is from Maynard on that low post position.
Teddy Duncan, number 34, a center, and Morgan Horn, the other forward, failed to score, Marty. So only three players for Sheldon Clark scored. For the Daredevils, you have two boys leading the Daredevils at halftime with 10 points each. Petey Grigsby, number 35, a guard for McDowell, who got things moving in the second quarter on the break. And also Frank Johnson, who's played a real hustling, inspired game all around, for particularly on the offensive board tonight. He's put in a couple of missed shots and put them back up and in. He has 10 points, and Grigsby has 10. Jimmy Turner, our 6'9 center, who is intimidating people in that middle, has 6 points and 7 rebounds. Roger Moore has 6 points, number 30. And Steve Hobart has 2 points. So, Marty, all five Daredevils chipped in the scoring column in the first half.
I think it shows a very balanced scoring there, Coach. McDowell getting out on the break. All the players are getting out on the break. And with Grigsby leading the break, he's always cognizant of the fact that he's always got two players breaking on either side. He has been hitting those two players when they're open. I noticed a couple of times on the break when Grigsby went all the way, Sheldon Clark was backing off, waiting for the pass, and Grigsby takes it all the way in. So they realize that Grigsby can pass the ball also.
That's right. He seems to have that knack to know when to penetrate and when also to kick the ball off. So when he's got the ball, anything can happen.
As you mentioned too, Coach, Johnson is playing a very inspiring game on the offensive board. And on the break, he scored a lot of his points on the offensive rebound, on the transition baskets on the break. And where McDowell is probably their weakest at tonight is on their point position on the defense and on the baseline.
Right, Marty. We're having the school song of McDowell led by band director Miss Judy Looney across the way. And our cameraman, Stevie Hall, is focusing on the majorettes and cheerleaders, a very spirited school song by the McDowell Daredevils. And they seem to have a very lively crowd here tonight, even though it's not quite as large as we have seen this year at McDowell.
I noticed, Coach, our cameraman is like all cameramen. He likes to focus in on the good-looking women.
He is a good cameraman, though, so let's keep him working. Marty, what's your guess this third quarter? Any changes in strategy?
I don't think McDowell needs to change any of their strategy. I think what you said, Coach, at the half, what Coach Turner should tell his boys, to keep playing the same type of game they're playing, take the shot when it's there instead of trying overplaying the ball. And I think they need to get a little bit more active on their baseline out of number 30 Moore and number 12 Howard. I know they're kind of awkward at that position. It's the first time they played it this year. But I think Coach Turner has something good here if he can ever get it to work.
I believe so. I believe in the long run you'll see that this change in his defensive assignments could be beneficial by tournament time to the Daredevils, even though right now you can tell they're having a little problem adjusting. But I thought they did an extraordinarily good job the second quarter, forcing Sheldon Clark to shoot beyond their range.
They did a fine job, and I suspect them coming out trying to do the same thing here at the half. Here we're just about ready to go, starting the third quarter with McDowell leading 34-21 as we have Turner jumping against Duncan and the post position. The ball goes up, Turner controls, tips it over, Maynard slaps it away. Moore's got it, rather. Moore gives it to Grigsby. Grigsby brings it up across the timeline, brings it down in the wing position.
He's dribbling the ball back over to Hobart at the on the point. Point. Johnson's got it down the baseline. He brings it back to Moore on the wing. Hobart got it on the point. Back to Johnson in the wing. They work it around. Looking inside at all times, trying to give the ball to Turner. Grigsby takes, stops, pops, and he's fouled.
There's a perfect example of what I said about getting into their offense. Petey had the penetration into almost an 8-foot jump shot, and he took it. And I think that's what they got to do. I think they got to take that first good opportunity defense gives them, and I think the Daredevils will be on their way.
Well, I noticed that McDowell was trying to get the ball into Turner. They were looking inside to him, but Sheldon Clark was closing it off. The ball comes in bounds to Grigsby, and he pops a 25-footer and makes it.
I believe that's 12 points for the guard. McDowell still under press, Marty. I think it's good move by the Daredevil coach, David Turner.
A lot of times, Coach, didn't you find when you were coaching that when your boys were playing not very tenacious on their defense that you put them into a press to make them run a little bit more?
I think that peps them up. That gets them moving, and they tend to concentrate on their defense, and that loosens up their offense.
Turner coming off the rebound over to Grigsby. He's going to run it down again. Here comes McDowell over to Moore. Oh, he missed a gimme there.
A gimme, yeah, right. And a beautiful feed there by Grigsby.
Maynard dribbling her all the way up. Takes it in, scores. Howard bringing the ball up across the timeline now. He brings it over to Grigsby. Grigsby takes it down the corner, looks inside to Turner, who jumps up to get it, turns. Good move.
There was
a good pass and a good move.
Good move and good pass, right. Here we're still in three-quarter pressure, now zone pressure. McDowell just seems to be trying to bother Sheldon Clark, run him into Turner.
Turner intimidating Kirk again. Turner slaps the ball over to Harvard. He's going to run it down now. Harvard slows it up and gives it over to Grigsby on the point. He's going to run the ball down, slaps it over to Moore, who's running in, gives it on the baseline on to Johnson, who puts it up and in.
Good movement of the ball that time, Marty. Brought the ball underneath the basket with three good crisp passes, moving the ball against that zone, which was overshifted, and Johnson has a layup.
McDowell kind of overloaded the zone that time. I think Grigsby dribbling down in his penetration. You mentioned it quite a few times tonight, Coach, where Grigsby has penetrated and kicked the ball off to the open man. Moore had a good 15-foot jump shot there and passed it up for the better percentage shot underneath to Johnson, who laid it up and in.
Right, it's very unselfish, and I feel like when McDowell is playing this type of game, they're really a tough ball club. They are leading 40-23 with 6 minutes to go in the third quarter, so they've extended their lead by by 4 points, and now leading by 17. And I believe we were right in our guesstimate that Coach Turner is just trying to do what he did successfully in the first half.
I think he's pressing a little bit more this half than he did the first half in order to get Moore and Hallward, I think, a little bit more active in their zone play.
Well, we've had a substitute come in.
Substitute come into the game, yeah.
David Tuttle, a junior,
David
number
Tuttle
20,
replaced Hallward.
Comes in for Hallward.
Tuttle is a little water bug out on the court. He likes to get active. And Sheldon Clark feeds low to Maynard down on the baseline. He gives it in the corner to Kirk. Kirk brings it back out on the wing to Horn. But goes back down deep into the corner to Kirk again. Kirk looking inside to Maynard, who's trying to work that low post. Horn with the ball back out on the point again, who feeds on the wing to Kirk. They're always looking inside, trying to go inside. They do now to Duncan. Duncan fakes Turner, goes up, no good. Tipped up and in by Horn.
Oh, look what they found on that tip in. But I think you see Sheldon Clark trying to go inside, establish inside game.
They are trying to force the ball inside. It's very obvious. Grigsby with a good move to the baseline, shoots it up, no good. Johnson again on the offensive board, gets the rebound, puts it up and back in.
Nice rebound, Frank. Good job.
There's McDowell with a steal on the press. Grigsby all the way in for the layup. Missed it. Johnson again on the offensive board. Tries to go back up, and he's fouled by Kirk. Coach, here we have, we mentioned it at the beginning of this quarter, Johnson very active on the offensive board again. He's come down with two strong offensive rebounds, put one of them back up in for a basket and was fouled on this one. This goes to the free throw, back up and in.
Frank's game has been coming along the past five or six games, both on defense and the boards. And he's chipping in, you know, with 8, 10, 12 points a game.
He hits both free throws, and here comes McDowell back after the press again. They're getting very active, trying to trap in the corner. Feeds up to the side, over to Kirk, who takes it all the way in, feeds it off to Horn, who lays it up off the glass and in. McDowell coming back down. Tuttle with the ball now. Tuttle feeding over to Grigsby. Grigsby back to Tuttle. Tuttle on the wing, feeds it in to Turner. Turner on the power move. He's fouled as he tries to go up with the ball. Grigsby substituting in the game. Number 14, Tommy McKinney into the game for Grigsby. What do you think the coach is trying to tell Grigsby on the side here, Coach?
He's concerned about his last jump shot there, but he just lost control of the shot. When you go up the ball and you lose a little bit of balance occasionally, the ball won't settle right in your hand. That's what happened.
There was a beautiful pass by Moore into Johnson on the low post. Johnson tried to go up with it and couldn't make it. Horn over to Horn on the wing. They're looking inside, back to Horn. Tries to go inside, bad pass. Turner's got it. McDowell coming back the other way. Tuttle to McKinney. McKinney one dribble, fakes, puts it up and in.
Nice fast break. McDowell's doing what they do best on the break.
McDowell's pushed up their lead now to 19 points, 46-27 with 3:49 to go here in the third quarter. Sheldon Clark breaks the press. Kirk puts it up, no good. Maynard with the rebound, takes it back up and in. Tuttle with the ball, brings it back up across the timeline. Oh, almost slapped away by Kirk, but he got him on the foul. Coach McDowell looks a little bit tired in the press right now. Sheldon Clark's beat it the last two times down the court and got two real good shots, made one and missed one. And McDowell's leading 46-29 here with 3:33 to go in the third quarter. Tuttle over to Moore, triggering the basket inbounds. Grigsby handling the ball on the point now. Grigsby down to Moore, who makes a move, puts it up. Good. Good move and a good shot by Roger Moore. McDowell setting up in their 1-2-1-1 press, full court. Sheldon Clark with the ball. Kirk triggers it into Horn, who gives it off to Maynard. Slapped away by Moore. Johnson trying to take it all the way. Good pass to Moore, puts it up. No good. He was fouled on the shot. There was a pretty good steal and a pretty good pass there, Coach. Johnson seems to be very active on defense tonight.
He's really moving good tonight. And Roger made a good play in the middle on defense. He hasn't been playing that position a whole lot all year, and he seems to be adjusting a little bit better to it. Of course, against that type of zone press, they're going to hit that middle, overload the middle, you see, and try to bring it down the sides after it hit the middle. And that's what Sheldon Clark did until that time Roger intercepted the pass.
Moore misses his first free throw, puts the next one up. Oh, and Johnson comes down with the rebound again, puts it up, no good. Moore down with the rebound, puts it up, and good. McDowell stretches their lead to 21 points, 50-29, with 2:54 to go here in the third quarter. Duncan in with on the inbounds pass. He throws it over to Horn, bringing it up across the timeline. He stops and gives it over to Kirk on the side. Kirk dribbling around the Horn. Stops and brings it back out to Horn. He brings it over to Horn on the wing, who puts it up, no good. The rebound comes off long to Maynard. Maynard tries to drive that baseline, dribbles it out of bounds.
Well, Sheldon Clark seems to be making turnovers now, Marty, and that's helping the Daredevil.
Here comes McDowell rushing the ball down the court, trying to get down before the defense sets up. Grigsby, very good pass to Johnson. It was slapped away, and the ball goes back to Sheldon Clark.
Oh, I didn't see that like that. I wasn't paying too much attention. I thought Sheldon Clark hit the ball out.
That's what I thought. Anyway, Sheldon Clark brings it in. Kirk triggering into Duncan, who gives it back to Kirk. Kirk gives it over to Horn, who brings it up across the timeline. Turner picks up the loose ball, gives it to Moore, who's going to go all the way in for the uncontested layup.
Well, the defense calls another turnover.
Here comes Maynard up with the ball. He's going to take it all the way in against Turner, who makes a good move. Intimidated a little bit by the long arms of Turner, who pulled it off the board, gives it to Tuttle. Tuttle over to Moore. Moore takes the 15-foot jump shot and hits it. McDowell pushing their lead on up. They're up to 24 points now. 25 points, correction. Kirk brings it down, and he's fouled by Tuttle.
There's a thing you want to discourage is fouling on the press. The press does a job when you bother the ball handlers of the other team, and it's bothering Sheldon Clark. The press is not put on other teams to foul. This is the thing that McDowell needs to control a little better, and they've controlled it real good so far. But there's a tendency once the press starts working for boys to start fouling. I hope they don't start that because it certainly will hurt their game.
Horn with a 25-footer, put it up and good. A very good set shot by Garfield Horn on the wing. Tuttle bringing the ball up. He brings it over to Grigsby. Grigsby penetrates, puts up a 15-footer and got it.
That 1-3-1 trap won't work against McDowell as long as they get the ball in position like that.
They're triggering the ball into Horn. Moore falls down, gives it into Horn to corner. Oh, and he puts it up and good.
I believe that's their first outside basket in this quarter, isn't it, Marty?
Horn hit one from about 25 foot there just the last time down the court and then made it. McDowell's lead at 23 right now, 56-33. Long pass down deep to Turner, who throws up the hook shot, misses it. Johnson on the offensive rebound again, put it up and in.
There's old hustling Frank again, right on that board.
There we've got Sheldon Clark triggering the ball into Maynard. Maynard gives it up to Horn on down the middle. Horn loses the ball, gets it back, goes into contest. He walked with the ball. There's intimidation again, Coach.
Absolutely. You see, McDowell can overplay and gamble when they got a 6'9 boy like Turner back there guarding the basket. It's a very good strategy by Coach Turner.
When you're a guard coach, it always feels good to know that you got someone about 6'9 standing behind you.
Absolutely. They can defend half a court if they just keep their feet. And Turner is doing that kind of job for them tonight, intimidating everything that's around the basket. And that's why McDowell's able to successfully gamble and make Sheldon Clark make the turnovers and intercept passes.
Well, Coach, all year long, Turner has been a very intimidating force here in the 15th region. He doesn't get that very active during the games, but he does keep his position very well. He doesn't leave his feet very often. He doesn't get faked out very often, as a lot of big men do when they go on the head and shoulder fake. Turner will usually keep his feet, and he does intimidate a lot of guards and a lot of small forwards. Now, there are a few other big men here in the region that he seems to have some trouble with, but that seems to be when he plays his best ball, though, is against the big man.
I think Jimmy has improved his game tremendously. He was in foul trouble consistently during the early part of the season and part of January, but now he's learning to stay out of foul trouble and win the foul. So I think that alone has improved his game tremendously this second half.
I think if he ever started working with the weights a little bit, get a little more strength about him, he could be a very awesome player. Tuttle working the ball down in the corner to Johnson now. Johnson brings it out to Tuttle, and Tuttle feeds it over to Grigsby. Grigsby feeds on the high post to Turner, who feeds it out on the wing to Moore. McDowell seems to be pulling it out here, trying to slow the play down to get the last shot of the quarter. They're leading by 25, 58-33. 10 seconds to go to the clock. McDowell makes their move now. Moore with an 8-foot jump shot, misses it. Sheldon Clark coming down with the ball. Oh, Kirk carried the ball, but got away with it. Puts up a 20-footer and makes it.
Cardinals were very fortunate that time. They got by with that turnover. But McDowell on top, 58-35, a 23-point lead. A very encouraging quarter for the Daredevils. The fact, Marty, that they were playing both ends of the court, defense and offense, in that quarter.
McDowell increased their lead to 23 points here in this quarter. Increased their lead by 10 points over the Cardinals. Cardinals were held only 14 points that quarter, but a lot of those points, Coach, came in the last 3 minutes of the quarter when McDowell's press, they started getting through the press a little better and hitting the shots they were missing previously in the quarter. So I think if McDowell can settle down, maybe pull back in their zone now and switch them up a little bit, they may be able to really blow.
Scoreboard. You've been getting a scoreboard.
Blow Sheldon Clark out here in the fourth quarter.
Well, it depends on the intensity of McDowell. If they don't relax and and they keep playing defense like they were earlier, and just don't let up on defense. I think McDowell is definitely headed for a very convincing victory here. But kids generally have a tendency to let down once they get a tremendous lead like they had.
Well, it'll be curious to watch them here in the fourth quarter. McDowell back out with the same lineup they started the game with at the beginning of the fourth quarter. Turner tips the ball to Grigsby, who's breaking 3-on-2. Grigsby takes a 15-foot jump shot, misses it. Turner with the offensive rebound, puts it back up and in. Grigsby doesn't seem to be hitting his shot as well as he normally does, Coach. Sheldon Clark coming back up the court. Horn has it over to Horn, who feeds it down low to Duncan, who goes up and back down. He was intimidated that time by Moore on the shot.
That's right. There's that good intimidation. Roger can jump as high as anybody his size. He does a good job for his height.
Halbert feeds it down on the wing to Moore. Moore brings it back out to Halbert. Grigsby feeds it down low to Turner, who makes a good pass across to Moore, takes it up, and he's fouled on the shot by Duncan.
Good movement of the ball and an excellent pass. An excellent pass from Jimmy Turner to Roger Moore on the weak side.
McDowell seems, Coach, not to be letting up as we thought they sometimes tend to do in the fourth quarter when they have the big lead. Stretch their lead back out to 25 points. Moore on the line, shooting two shots. First one up is good. McDowell holds their biggest lead of the night at 26. Moore with the second shot, takes a couple of dribbles, puts it up, and it comes off, and Duncan's got the rebound. Duncan over to Kirk, who drains it across the timeline. He's working one-on-one against Halbert. He brings it back out to Horn on the point. Horn to Horn on the wing. Back to Horn on the point, who takes the 25-foot shot, misses it. Grigsby off with the rebound, and he's going to push her up the floor. He pushes her down low to Halbert, who makes a good move, misses the shot. Turner with the rebound, puts it back up and in.
Nice rebound by Turner. Good pass
by
Grigsby.
That was a good pass by Grigsby. Halbert just missed the shot. He had to adjust his shot a little bit. McDowell still with a press, with good pressure, almost had the steal. Johnson, I think, fouled on the pass there.
That was on the trap, yes. They had a good trap set up there and almost got by with it, but the referee's a little cagey there and caught him on the, must have been a slapped wrist or something.
A lot of times they'll catch that, a lot of times they won't. That was just one of the times that they do call it. Maynard bringing it all the way down. Adjusts his shot because Turner's there. Turner brings the rebound off. Gives it over to Halbert. Halbert almost loses the ball. Brings it over to Grigsby. Grigsby settles down, looks across the court, sees what he's got, brings it over to Halbert. Halbert over to Moore. Down low to Turner. Oh, almost had the good pass again. Deflected by Duncan. Kirk's got it going all the way in. Misses the shot. Maynard with the rebound. Puts it back up. No good. Moore with the rebound. Turner with the rebound. Turner fires off to Grigsby, stolen by Horn. Horn out, Kirk adjusted. He walked that time and got away with it. He looked at Turner and walked that time, Coach, and got away with it.
Yes, it is.
That's one way to get around a big man. If you can't dribble around him, run around him. Feeds it down low to Johnson. Johnson to Turner. Turner puts it up off the glass. No good. Rebound by Johnson. Offensive again. Up, no good. Tipped up by Turner. Takes it down. Tries to go back up with it. He's fouled by Maynard. Good board work there on the offensive board.
Frank Johnson and Jimmy Turner were really going after those boards that time. I really like that type of rebounding. They put it up against the glass four times. They still kept the ball alive, and even though it didn't come away with a basket, they got two foul shots out of it.
I tell you, when you're down there trying to get that rebound for the defensive team and you got two players just standing up there and playing patty cake with the ball, frustrating sometimes. Turner hits both free throws. McDowell goes up by 28 here with 5:50 to go in the fourth quarter. The score, McDowell 65, Sheldon Clark 37.
Greg Short has replaced Johnson in the lineup for McDowell. Greg's a senior, and he does a good job backing up the forwards for Coach Turner.
It's a well-deserved rest for Johnson. Kirk dribbles it all the way up the court, feeds off to Maynard, who puts up the shot, misses it, Moore down with the rebound, feeds it off to Halbert, who's trying to bring it up the court. Halbert over to Grigsby. Grigsby cut off on the penetration, goes in now, shoots it, shot is blocked. Moore down with it, puts it up, no good. Rebound by Maynard. Maynard bring it down, feeds to Kirk on the break. Kirk stops and goes up with it and is good. Halbert brings it into Grigsby. He brings it across the timeline. Grigsby down in the corner to Turner. Turner feeds it inside to Moore. The shot goes up, blocked. Moore tries to go up with it again, blocked again, but he's fouled. Moore got away with two shoulders and a stomach that time. That's a good offensive ploy. Get your man up, go in his ribs, push him off, and go up with the ball.
Well, that is an example of a type of play that we've seen here tonight underneath the boards. It's been like that for both teams, but McDowell being far and above the most aggressive this last half.
McDowell stretched her lead out to 26 points here. With 5:05 to go here in the fourth quarter. Moore has missed the first free throw, shooting the second one. Puts it up. Good. Sheldon Clark triggers the ball in. Kirk will trigger it in to Maynard in the corner. Maynard back to Kirk. Kirk trying to bring it up by himself, dribbling. Finally gets it across the timeline. He's met there by Moore. And short. Finally breaks loose, gives it off to Horn, who comes over in the wing to Horn. He tries to put it up, feeding down low to Maynard. The shot was blocked, but they got him with the body, they says. Turner with the body. That'll put Maynard on the line, shooting two free throws. McDowell leading by 27 points here in the fourth quarter. Coach, McDowell stretched their lead 4 points here so far. They haven't had that much of a letdown.
No, they haven't. McDowell is still playing a good, steady ball and very aggressive. Seems like they've gotten more aggressive this half as the game has gone on. Here's Frank Johnson in for Roger Moore.
Here with almost 4 minutes gone, 3 minutes gone here in the fourth quarter, McDowell's held Sheldon Clark to only 6 points. 5 points, correction, 5 points. Maynard with both free throws up and good. Here comes Grigsby. Grigsby over to Halbert. Down low to Short, who sets, shoots, good. Short got set with his shot, put it up and put it through.
That's Greg's specialty. He can shoot out on the floor like that when he gets time.
Trigger in to Horn. Horn back to Kirk. Kirk's going to dribble it across. Kirk to Horn. Horn takes it in the middle, puts it up. Good.
Well, our big boy just didn't get his hands up. I believe he would intimidate him if he had. But he's done an excellent job
Horn
tonight.
Horn brings down the corner to Short. Short tries to set up, feeds it in low to Johnson. Johnson puts it up and in. 70-43 here. 27-point lead by the Daredevils of McDowell. Here comes Kirk dribbling the ball up the court again. And he's fouled by Halbert on the far on the right-hand side of the court.
Here's Roger Moore and David Tuttle back in the lineup for the Daredevils.
We've got a timeout on the court, Coach. McDowell taking the timeout. And we'll give our cameraman a break. Here we are back after the timeout. McDowell back onto the court. It'll be Sheldon Clark's ball on the right-hand side of the court. Kirk will trigger it in.
Well, Coach Turner has two of his starters on the bench and has Tuttle and Greg Short in there. Looks like they've gone man-to-man. They have.
Kirk working one-on-one, misses a shot. Moore off of the rebound, gives it off to Tuttle, falling down. Tuttle brings it all the way up the court, takes it up, missed the shot. And Moore on the offensive rebound, I think, was a little too aggressive, fouling there. Tuttle was all over the place on that shot. Garfield Horn on the line for Sheldon Clark. He'll shoot one with a bonus. Takes a few dribbles. Puts the ball up. good. Horn with the second shot, puts it up, got it. McDowell's lead cut to 25 now, 70 to 45. Tuttle brings it in to Grigsby, who's going to bring it across the timeline. He makes a move, goes up from 15 foot, got it.
That's a good move, Marty. He got by two defensive men and penetrate to foul line with a good jumper.
Grigsby almost with a steal that time. Maynard bringing it across. He's going to take it all the way through, and he missed the layup. It was fouled on the shot.
McDowell's having a little problem adjusting right now. Coach Turner put him in man-to-man, I'm sure, to give him some work in it and to keep them sharp. They're experiencing a little bit of problems in the adjustment, however, and I think this is the reason for the fouling that they've done here in the past couple of plays down the court against Sheldon Clark.
Is this a good ploy by Coach Turner to go into the man-to-man? Is he just using Sheldon Clark to practice his man-to-man? Or?
I think so. I think he's using it as a practice situation to keep his man-to-man sharp if he ever needs it.
Sheldon Clark trying to trap now, but they get it low to Turner, who goes up with a shot and got it in. Hard to stop a man 6'9 when he gets that far low on the baseline. Maynard back across the timeline for Sheldon Clark. He makes a spinning move on the baseline, puts it up, no good. Tapped up by Duncan and good.
Oh, nice tip. I didn't know that kid could jump that high.
Tuttle bringing it across to Grigsby. Grigsby setting the offense up, tries to go way low to Moore. The ball is stolen away. Horn feeds it way down the court to Kirk, who waits. Duncan stood in that lane about 10 seconds, our coach, but got away with it. Here comes McDowell back on the other end, feeding it low to Turner, who goes up with a shot off the glass and good.
Good feed, good pass, good shot.
Good pass, good shot.
Nice soft touch against the board. The ball just nestled right in the goal.
Kirk bringing her back, working one-on-one on Tuttle, goes all the way in, makes the layup good. Here comes Tuttle coming back up the court with the ball. Frank Johnson about to report in for McDowell. We've got a blocking foul just now called on Maynard. That'll put David Tuttle on the line shooting a bonus. Johnson coming back into the game, coach, replacing Greg Short. I think they've missed Johnson's offensive board work there.
You can tell the difference with him out of there. He is probably one of the leading rebounders, if not the leading rebounder. I do not have any stats from McDowell tonight to tell you, but I can assure you he's in the top two.
Tuttle up with his shot, misses goal and everything. Duncan off of the board, comes back down, across to Maynard. Maynard working one-on-one on Turner. Maynard gives it off to Kirk, works one-on-one on Tuttle, goes up. Moore tips the ball. Johnson off of the rebound, gives it to Grigsby, down on the court. He gives it back up to Johnson, back over to Tuttle. Turner trying to go up for the shot, and he's slapped away.
That was good reaction there by Johnson and Grigsby. I thought it was pretty good.
I think Johnson tried to get rid of the ball because he thought he was going to walk with it. And Grigsby land on the court, gives it back up to Johnson after he get himself under control. McDowell works the ball real well inside. Moore scores the basket. And they come back up the court for Sheldon Clark for Maynard. Going across, going to go all the way. Stops, pops. Caught McDowell a little bit asleep there. But Turner had his back to Maynard, and McDowell was a little bit snoozing on that play. Turner has it. They are going to call him for walking. He lifts his pivot foot up. Turner looks to be a little tired, coach.
Yeah, the big boy seems a little tired. They haven't played for a week. I think this is a good conditioning game for McDowell. They play later this week, two more games, but right now Coach Turner needs to play.
Kirk is eating Tuttle up on this one-on-one, on this man-to-man defense. Grigsby has it now with a 15-foot jump shot, puts it up, no good. Maynard off with the rebound, feeds it to Horn. Horn trying to get it back over to Kirk and throws it way back outside. Kirk runs it down, feeds it inside to Duncan. Duncan sees Turner, puts it up anyway and goes in. McDowell's lead cut to 19 now, coach, 78-59 with 40 seconds to go in the quarter. This game winding down to end, been a good ball game. Grigsby's gonna go off, feeds it off to Turner on a good pass. Turner lays it up off the glass very softly, puts it in. McDowell's lead back up to 21, 80-59 with 25 seconds to go. That was a good penetrating move and a good pass, Coach. I thought Grigsby was going to shoot it.
He does a good job of that. You never know when he's going to dump it off or hit the basket.
Horn way outside. Grigsby almost with a rebound. Maynard trying to go back in. He's fouled. The goal will count. The foul will be on 52 Turner. McDowell's lead back down to 19. 10 seconds to go in the quarter. I think McDowell has this game locked up with a 19-point lead. 10 seconds to go. Maynard will be at the line, shooting one free throw. Coach, your observations of tonight's game.
Well, I think McDowell has done what they normally do best, and that's fast break the ball down the floor, push it down, get on the boards, and take the good shot.
Roger Moore put it up and in on a long pass by Johnson. 3-2-1 Horn up. Goes as good, it doesn't. This ball game is history. 82-62 McDowell 20-point lead, 20-point winners over Sheldon Clark Cardinals.
You know, I feel like that 82 points is a good score in anybody's league, and McDowell can score that way and play good defense like they have. I think that they'll do a good job. I have a message from someone in the stands. Is Coach Hall here tonight? No, he must not be here, I don't believe. That was sent to us by one of our premier officials in this area, Mr. Chucky Hall. Let's see how the scoring went tonight, Marty. Let's take for the winning team, the McDowell Daredevils. Pete Grigsby had 16, a little below his average, but a good floor game and a good assist game. Steve Hobart had 2 points. Jimmy Turner had 20 points, real strong last half there. Jimmy had six field goals. Roger Moore came in with 20 points, and Frank Johnson, I guess, on his season high with 20. So McDowell had four players with in double figures. Greg Short came in and hit a 25-footer off the bench for 2 points. Tom McKinney had 2 points on a fast break layup. David Tuttle, who played quite a bit, didn't score, but he played a good floor game and gave a lot of hustle to the Daredevils and defensive potential while he was in there.
I think David Tuttle come in and gave McDowell a real good spark with his hustle and his play out front. I think it should be pointed out here, Coach, that Turner and Moore and Johnson, a lot of their baskets came on offensive rebounds. They were hitting the boards real hard tonight, and they got the ball back off the board, put it back up on the missed shots. Got a lot of their points in that direction.
That is very good balanced scoring. If McDowell can continue that, they're going to be lots of trouble in the district and regional. He had Pete Grigsby had a bundle of assists. We didn't keep the assists tonight, but he must have had at least a dozen. And that contributed to a lot of baskets by Turner, particularly, and Moore on the fast break. Let's look at Sheldon Clark here. Marty? Maynard, the two guards ended up, Kirk, one guard with 16, and Maynard, the other guard with 22. So, that's 38 points.
Well, Coach, I should
out of the guards.
I should point out that Kirk got 8 points there in the fourth quarter. All 8 of those points, or at least 6 of them, came after McDowell went into the man-to-man, and he ate Tuttle's lunch there on a few occasions.
Yeah,
he got easy baskets on layups, a lot of uncontested baskets. So really their guard play, it looked good the first half. They really looked strong because that's where most of their points come from. As it ended up, most of their points in the game come from their guard and that shooting forward position of Garfield Horn.
Yes, Garfield Horn had 16, and of course most of those points came in the third quarter. After that, he was shut out. But really, the cut into McDowell's lead came when I want to get Coach Turner on here in a minute, when he experimented around and gave boys a little practice on that man-to-man. I think he had him down much more decisively. And, of course, he's given the boys some pretty good practice, I think.
Of course, Maynard with 22 points on the game. But as I look here, 9 of those came in the fourth quarter when Coach Turner did go into the man-to-man. McDowell, not being able to play that much and practice that much in the previous games, didn't look that well in their man-to-man, but it was good practice for them. Maynard was fouled quite a bit, made 5 free throws there in the fourth quarter. So, Coach, their guards did supply most of their offensive power, but it came too little too late, I'm afraid to say.
Right. The final score, McDowell 82 and Sheldon Clark 62, and McDowell wins their 18th game of the season. Congratulations, Coach Turner. What's your view of the game tonight?
Well, you guys evidently were shocked when I went to a man-to-man. I did that for Coach Newsom's benefit. Betsy Lane, he was here looking at us, and I thought I'd go to a man-to-man, see what he thought about it. I don't guess he thought much of it after we lost a 30-point lead. But
I thought you were practicing up a little bit, Coach. I didn't know what you were showing. You were showing that to Coach Newsom.
The things that I can see here on the book that really pleased me is Kirk, number 14, had 16 points, and Horn had 16 points. Horn had 35 points against Virgie, and this guy had 15 or 16. He got about the same that he got against Virgie, but if you'll look in the second quarter, you'll see, 7 points for the whole basketball team. Sheldon Clark's team.
They scored seven points in the second quarter.
And one guy got all of them.
We pointed that out in them.
It wasn't either one of those two guys. That was our intentions, to shut those two guys down. And we did it in the second quarter.
Coach Grigsby and I made that observation in the first quarter where Kirk and Horn were getting the ball well within their range to shoot, and they were hitting those shots. And we thought that maybe you would pull out and put a little bit more pressure on them on the point and on the wings to try to shut their shots off. And I was surprised to see Maynard, they've got him listed as guard, but he played low post most tonight.
Right. He evidently, he's the quickest guy they have on the basketball team. he took the ball outside and went inside when we went to the man-to-man. He just drove by us and laid it in, and then he posted up in the zone. He tried to post up on the back man some, but they just wasn't looking for that tonight.
I thought the whole turnabout of a game and a change of a game came when you did force their shots outside in the second quarter, controlled the rebounds, and then got the ball to Grigsby on the fast break with him going down the middle. I think that broke the game open to your 10-12-point lead, and certainly you have to give your defensive game, your rebounding game, and your fast break all the credit. I think that was a turning point of the game, and certainly how do you feel about that in the second quarter?
Two things happened in the second quarter. We had been pressing out of a front situation, and they were breaking it and scoring on us in the first quarter. We were giving their two outside shooters their shots. They had 12 out of their 14 points, those two guys. In the second quarter, we went to a regular trap press and pressured the two wing shooters, and I thought when you can shut a team to 7 points in one quarter, I think that pretty well set the tone for the game.
Yeah, and then when you can push the ball out like you did, control the rebounds, it's going to be difficult to stop the Daredevils when they can run like that. Of course, you can't run if you don't have the rebounds and play the defense, as we both know. Did you notice how your change of your defensive assignments at first seemed to improve a whole game or not? What's your comments on your – I noticed you had changes in your defensive assignments tonight.
We have a faster man on the baseline that our thinking on that was he could get to those shooters a little quicker than Steve. We moved Steve out to the point. And that was going to be my next question to you. I was going to ask you how you liked our change.
We were very impressed with the change, to say the least, Coach. The only thing that we noticed is that Moore and Hallward had a little bit of trouble adjusting to the new positions. Moore had a tendency to sometimes want to play his wing position, and Hallward got caught, we noticed, one time trying to play the baseline again when he should have been out front. But I think given time and working with it, That's the defense you'll probably go with the rest of the year.
I noticed, too, one comment when Petey got the rebound, he took it down the middle, pushed the ball down the floor, and that looked like a good move because you're able to fill the outside lanes and you even had fast breaks off rebounds.
Right. I wasn't too pleased with us in the first quarter, but we had a good second quarter and a good third quarter and a good –
first
half
4 minutes
of
the fourth quarter.
Then we sort of let up. But overall, I thought we, at times we looked like a real good basketball team. And when you can win, a win is a win.
Number 18, Coach, congratulations to you and the Daredevils tonight. Wrap it up, Marty.
Coach, it's been a pleasure working with you. The final score of tonight's ball game: McDowell 82, Sheldon Clark 62. McDowell with their 18th win on the season. Their next game will be this coming Friday night against the Mustangs of Millard over at Millard. And we wish that everyone will come and see us again at that time.